is something else. A man who has exploded on the scene, Intercontinental Champion, the Ultimate Warrior.
Hulk Hogan!
At WrestleMania 6,
I bring you the one and only Ultimate Challenge!
Ultimate Warrior, me and my Hulkamaniacs put the championship on the line.
The main event in WrestleMania 6, the Ultimate Warrior squaring off against Hulk Hogan.
Oh, my.
When I said that WrestleMania 6 was more intense than all five WrestleManias put together, I meant it, brothers.
You are about to enter a world close to parts unknown.
WrestleMania 6, the most important day for the rest of our lives.
Do you, Hulk Hogan, look for a place to hide, or do you face that challenge?
What you gonna do when the largest arms in the world run wild on you?
You will know, Hulk Hogan, who is the Chosen One.
This is the main event of WrestleMania 6. It is scheduled for one fall, and it is title for title. Introducing first, weighing 275 pounds, he is the Intercontinental Champion, the Ultimate Warrior. Listen to the ovation for the Ultimate
Warrior. And then do a match.
I love it. And I love that he's got the yellow title, too.
And that's what this is. He's
got to be authentic, you know? Of course. That's what this mode's all about. Recreating these classic matches, these iconic conflicts between WWE legends, really.
He had to get everything right, from the championship titles to the overlay graphics, everything.
And his opponent,
here we come. These are two of my favorite matrices in the game, honestly. They give me tingles, both of these. They give me tingles. Look at this. Look at this.
These are both great. I think
I'm doing that, and people can't see, but I'm doing the hand motions. I'm so stoked.
What cool is, man?
Yeah,
he's good.
And I love the accurate crying and lettering the names and things like that.
Yeah, again, you know, point to the fact, you know, all their authenticity, brother. Of course, you got to get everything. You know,
the cuts on the back of the tank top.
Exactly.
Picture perfect.
WrestleMania 6.
And he doesn't do it in this one. What he actually do at Hogan.
Both men are in tremendous physical condition, JR.
Really going to look
at that.
And
here's
something else I'm really stoked about. The Fink. The Fink. The Fink is in the ring with the WWE superstars at WrestleMania. They're the Fink belongs.
Exactly.
Finkus Maximus. He's there.
It's not WrestleMania without the Fink. Come on. And again, look at how authentic that looks.
It's beautiful.
Yeah. I mean, after seeing that video package and that was interesting, man, I'm pumped.
And I love this.
Yeah.
Perfectly capturing the grandeur.
Oh boy, look at the goal.
WrestleMania.
This should be an outstanding match.
That's what it's all about. You got one fan favorite against another fan favorite.
Check this out.
Checking the knee pads.
Hulk's fixing the knee pads.
Warrior's
going for it immediately.
Oh yeah, right off the bat. So if anybody's watching this for the first time, anyone familiar with WWE 13 and what we didn't have here, you kind of have the same infrastructure or blueprint. You've got your objectives on the upper left corner of the screen there. Let you know what you need to do.
Warrior, look at those taunts. I love it.
I love them too.
I love both these guys' taunts in this game. It's fantastic.
Warrior's dyslexic. That is the consummate warrior right there. But you're right, Hogan's got some good taunts as well. Look at that, he's leveling.
So tell us a little bit about the objectives here, like what they trigger. Tell us about the WrestleMania moments.
Yeah, well, you know, as I was mentioning, like the first objective, the historical one, you got an Irish with Hogan when his damage was light. So you got this cool little gauge on there that lets you know where he's at, the opponent damage. And we got these hidden objectives. And I was getting asked today, how do I trigger these hidden objectives? Am I gonna miss them? All you gotta do is play the match. The hidden objectives will make themselves known to you at that right moment.
Man, Warrior's flexing, man.
I know.
Every opportunity.
Showing the guns, son.
Now, just so fans know, who are you playing as in this match?
I'm playing as the winner. Okay. I am playing Warrior. As Warrior. And that's another thing.
Spoiler alert.
Yeah.
Look at this. Oh. And that's one of our WrestleMania moments.
It is.
This is, and what a WrestleMania moment is it's our game's exact recreation of a thing that happened in real life.
During the match, yes.
To give you the most authentic experience playing these matches as possible.
And some of those moments are, you know, quick time events. Some of them are just, you know, cutscenes interspersed with the gameplay. This one is just a cutscene that happens in the game, but we have some other ones later on in the match that we'll get to.
Here's my favorite part.
I know.
Here it is. I love it. I love seeing it.
He's getting the power from the cosmos, man. That warrior
strength.
He's
feeling the power, man. Always believe. Always believe.
Oh, yeah. Always, man.
Warriors going to be here.
Hulk Hogan had his vitamins. Ultimate Warriors got his face paint and the moons and the suns and the galaxies.
The body language is so perfect. The body language is exactly like people remember these matches.
And then transition right back into gameplay.
We'll test the strength between these gentlemen. Warrior wins it.
Your fundamental textbook suplex right there.
Nice. So now we've got to complete the first WrestleMania moment.
And right, that's our next objective.
And this will come about organically, correct?
Exactly, yes. Again, all you got to do is play the match itself and it'll make itself known.
Man, Warrior doing all those taunts, working those signatures up, man.
Well, you know, it's all about entertaining.
And I love this attack, too. Just brutal.
Yeah, that's perfect for Warrior.
That's one of the things I love about this match is that, you know, neither of these guys are Daniel Bryan. You know, they're not latching all these crazy submissions. They're not doing crazy kicks. The brawlers, they're big, beefy guys, brawling, suplexing.
In old school terms, it's power merchants.
You're correct.
I read my PWA
five. These guys are problems. And
they are.
And they wrestle in a very specific way. And in the game, they wrestle like they did in real
life. I mean, like you said, you're not going to get too fancy out of either one of these guys. I mean, it's clubbing blows, suplexes, body slams, just enough to get you down so they can do, you know, each effective finish.
Would you say that there was any clubbering going on?
There's some clubbering going on in this match. In this match and a couple others in the boat.
Wait a minute, what's he doing here?
And I just got to say, I love playing as Ultimate Warrior, man. I really do.
I love this move, too. You may have noticed in playing with me, Ryan, I like to work the corners. I like to use the turnbuckles.
No, we play the same way. We have similar styles.
Very similar styles.
Look, another flex, man.
Oh, man.
Oh no.
Hogan going for the DDT.
Look at this guy.
I love it. Hulkster. Hulkamaniacs.
I know. Yeah. Again, it's all about putting on a show. The boot to the face for his trouble to do so. Trying to upstage the Warrior. Warrior going to the top rope. Look at that.
Not a common thing for Warrior.
I know, but you know, one of those things. The golden video game, you know?
After that accident, it's very bold.
I wanted to work this match. Take more chances than he did in the actual match.
It's one of the things that we haven't mentioned yet. That is one of my favorite new things about the game.
What's that? It's
a reversal system.
The
changes made to the reversal system.
The changes made, you know, mostly are affected by the chain grapple system. Last year's game, two skilled opponents like yourself, you know, me, would get into a play of the game. It'd just be one constant set of reversals after reversal, with neither one of us putting out an offensive move. We've addressed that this year so that if I counter a move that you perform on me, I'm going straight into a move of my own. So you get a satisfaction of one, having reversed an attack, and two, having performed an attack of your own. So it just, you know, speeds up the gameplay, you know, allows both players to kind of get in and out of their offense a lot faster.
And it feels more like WWE television, which is what I like most about it.
And here's the WrestleMania move. Oh, and you got a ref bump. Uh-oh.
And so that's one of the examples of the quick time WrestleMania.
Right, exactly. And that was a short one. We have another cool one coming up later on in the match. That's my personal fave. And so I think all the Hulkamaniacs will love it, too.
Ref's getting back up. Warrior going right back to it. Clubbering
time. So now we've opened up those hidden objectives. Like I said, just playing the match, playing the game. Go make themselves known.
There's not a lot of searching around. There's not a lot of guessing. It's natural. It's natural,
and more importantly, it's fun.
Oh, look at this.
I know, right?
We're going for the leverage.
Probably the most technical maneuver that he's done.
Working outside the box.
Exactly. But yeah, like I was saying, just going back to the objectives, you know, these objectives are so much more fun to accomplish in this year's game, and they feel less of a chore than maybe they could feel in the last one.
Belly-to-belly suit play.
Yeah. Oh, and look at this guy again. You gotta give the crowd what they want.
And this is the AI. I think that's important to point out.
Playing
like Hogan.
Playing like Hogan.
Fantastic.
Showing off his
personality. Here's that gorilla press as part of the historical objective.
That's right.
Boom.
So I hit it on him, and now I gotta pin him. And by doing that, boom, it triggers the next moment of the match. And this is good. You know, just as an aside, man, I gotta say, like, doing mocap for this year's game was just, I mean, it's always a fun time, but watching the guys, you know, reenact these moments, it was something else, man.
This is amazing. I love this Hogan cut scene.
Yeah,
come back
to
the no sell and the hulking up.
I mean, our guys did a tremendous job with this. And you know, really selling the moment of the act of, you know, of everything, too. And letting everything resonate.
That's another one of these quick times.
Yep. Boom. Uh-oh.
You
didn't like that. Didn't like that one bit.
Hey man, I thought you said that Warrior was going to win this match.
Did I say that?
Yeah, but I mean, look what's happening right now.
He's going for the
classic.
And he missed it, and we're right back
and
in
that's
the game.
And that's the second WrestleMania moment.
That's it. So now I got to hit my finish on him.
I love this. Boom.
Best pin in the game.
And look at this pin.
Best pin in the game.
Incredible.
So disrespectful. So disrespectful to Hogan.
He's the Warrior. He earned it.
He did.
WWE Champion, Intercontinental Champion. Watch this.
A pass another torch.
Check this out. This is the best.
Yo, and this is really why I wanted to show this match, because this victory scene is amazing.
It's such a great payoff.
It is.
To the match itself. And it's a fun match, but this, it's the keystone.
This is it, you know? Like you said, Intercontinental,
show respect.
The WWE Champion,
two million competitors.
That's it. He laid it all on the line in the match. Two championships.
I think if I'm wrong, this is the first ever title for title match in WWE.
Was it?
I believe so, yeah.
All right, I'll let you say that.
I'm sure people online will be telling me I'm
wrong. Yeah, exactly.
Right now.
I think it probably was WrestleMania for sure. You know what? You're probably right.
Of course I'm right.
When are you ever wrong?
Of course I'm right.
And boom, look at that. I love that shot. Oh, man.